Hello everyone, today we are going to see the exercise for C programming, the first exercise, operators, expressions and IO formatting. First we will cover what you mean by operators, expressions and IO formatting. Then we will see the basics needed for writing an algorithm and flowchart, and then we will narrate a simple program that explore all the some of the operators in the C and a program that covers all these three topics, right? Now, what do you mean by an operator? It is a symbol that tells the compiler to perform some mathematical or logical manipulation. Normally, they are meant for manipulating data. So, what is expression? Expression is nothing but combination of operators and variables. What is IO formatting? I stands for input, that is the way the user can feed data into the program, and O stands for output, the way through which the programmer or the user can get output or can get data from the programmer. And your C support some inbuilt functions to perform this input and output operations. We will see them in a programmer. The next is, okay, first we will see what is algorithm. Before we start writing any program, we need to first write your algorithm and flowchart, and then you go for program in case of your structured programming. Your C is a structured programming. So what is algorithm means? It is a step-by-step process for solving a problem, and each step you call it as instruction. Now we will see an example where you have to write algorithm for adding two numbers A and B and store the result in C. So first you have to write start. The first instruction is you have to start. Then you have to read the values for A and B. You have to read the values for A and B. Then you have to apply the suitable operator for the program you need for add two numbers. So you add A and B and store the result in variable C. Then you have to display the result, that is the variable C value has to be displayed, and finally you end it. This is what the step-by-step instruction that has to be converted into programming language, if at all it has to be executed in a by a computer. The next as a continuation we will see what should be the algorithm for a simple program to explore basic arithmetic operators, comparison operators and logical operators in C. I have to start the program. To explore, I'm going to initialize. I'm not going to read value from the user. Instead, I'm going to initialize values for A and B as 10 and 5. Then I'm going to display the results after applying arithmetic operators on the variables A and B. I'm then going to display the result after applying comparison operators on A and B. Then I'm going to display the result after applying logical operators on A and B. What or how these operators work, we will see with an example programmer. Now, flowchart. Flowchart is nothing but pictorial representation of your algorithm. You call it as flowchart. This is for easy understanding. So we have listed some basic symbols. This symbol represents, this oval symbol represents your starting and end point. And this arrow indicates the relationship between different representations in your flowchart. And then this parallelogram represents input and output operation. For example, your read and display will be represented by this parallelogram. Then your rectangle represents the process or the task. For example, add A plus B will be represented by this rectangle. Then you have diamond symbol. This is for decision making, which we will be discussing in our second exercise. Okay, now we will look at a problem to write a program to take input, and this program will take input as name, roll number, marks obtained by a student in four subjects of 100 marks each, and then the result has to be, you have to display the same, the name, whatever you have read, name, roll number, but instead of marks, you are going to display the percentage scored by the particular student. Okay. Before we see this problem in detail, we will first see what are the operators I have to apply on this. To have an idea, we will see a program that explores the basic arithmetic operators. Right? So, this is an online platform to execute your program. So, here we are going to, in my program, I have initialized, as we see in the algorithm, I have initialized the values of A and B, right? And now, first we are going to see, apply basic arithmetic operators and see, and then we will see the comparison operators. So, first when I apply, we will see what happens. On execution of the statement, the values are being initialized. Then on execution of this printf, what is this printf statement means? This is an output inbuilt function helps to display the output to the user from the programmer, right? Since I have given whatever you give within the double quotes, that will be displayed as such. So I have given arithmetic operator, so it is printed as such. And this is a new line symbol. This backslash n represents new line. So when the next line will be printed on the next dotted will be printed on the next line. So this is one output inbuilt output function that with, if you give whatever you give within the double quotes, that will be printed as such, right? Okay. Now we will see. So here again I am using an output function. So whatever I give in the double quotes, that will be printed as it. So what is this percentage D? This you call it as format specifier. What it will do means, this format specifier will be replaced by the value that is given after this double quote separated by comma, right? So this percentage D will be replaced by the value of A plus B. Here the plus is your arithmetic operator addition, right? Okay. And normally this format specifier, you have many things. This D is meant for integer representation. In the same program, we have also discussed for character. We will see that later. So on applying A plus B, you have the value as 15. The next is your subtraction operator. We know it do subtraction. The next is your multiplication operator. Yeah, it multi. Then is your division operator. Right. Then is your division operator. And the next comes your modulus operator. This modulus operator will always return the remainder of the division, right? So the remainder is here 0. So it returns 0. Then comes your comparison operators. So it will print as such, right? Then comparison in general tells the relationship between two operand. Here you call A and B as operand, and this greater than symbol as your operator. So it will represent the relationship. If the relationship is true, it will return 1. Otherwise, it will return 0. In our case, the relationship is true. A, that is A value is 10. So A will be greater than B because B value is 5. So let us see what is being displayed. Yes, it is displayed as 1. The next relationship says A is greater than or equal to. Yes, it is greater than, right? So it has to display 1. Then the third relationship says A is less than B. No, it is not. So it will display the value as 0, right? Again, A is less than or equal to. No, again it displays 0. The last says A equal to, right? Here, you have to understand one thing. Here we had A equal to 10. That means we are assigning the value 10 to the variable A. This is assignment operator. The value 10 is assigned to the variable A, right? Here you have double equal to. This is a comparison operator. Here you are comparing the value of A and B. If both A and B has same value, then it will return 1. Let us see. It is not equal, so it returns 0. Then the next says the value of A and B are not equal. Yes, the value of A and B are not equal, so it returns 1. This is what the comparison operator. This will be of great use when you go for your logical writing. The last is your logical operators. The logical operators, they are mainly used along with the expression. So what is expression? The expression is nothing but if you are going to combine your operators and variables together. This is an example of an expression. Here the first says, I am saying the value of A is equal to 5. If it is so, it will be true. Then I am saying A value is greater than B. If it is true, then it will be true value. The purpose of AND is, if both are true, then it will return true. Right? That means always the both the condition has to be true to get a true value. If either of them is false, you will not get the true value. Right? That is what AND. Both the condition has to be true. OR means either one condition has to be true, then that is fine. NOT means the reverse. So in the first case, both the conditions are. What is the value of A? We have given the value of A as 10. So the first condition, right? So the first condition itself false. So it will not go and check for the second condition. It will return as false, 0, right? The next, here the first condition is false, but the second condition is true. So it returns 1. Third, the A equal to 5 is false. So I have to return the opposite because I have applied NOT. So it returns 1. So this program is to give basic ideas on arithmetic comparisons and logical operator. With this understanding, we will move to our problem. Right. So in the problem, we need to take input of name, roll number and marks. That means you need to know about the input function used in your C, right? That is scanf. We will discuss it. Then as an output means we will be using printf statement. We have to display name, roll number and percentage. I am getting input as mark, but I have to return percentage. So what is the task I have to do? I have to read the name, roll number, the marks of all the four subjects. To get the percentage, I have to add all the four marks, right? Apply arithmetic operator plus, then I have to divide it by 4 to get the percentage, right? So, okay, to get the percentage. Percentage will be normally in floating point, right? So, you will be using the format specifier F. First, we will write the algorithm. You have to start the program, define variables, name, roll number, and all the variables to store all the subjects, and finally the score variable to sum it up. Then you take input from the keyboard for all the input variables. Then you calculate the sum of all four subjects, and also you calculate the percentage, that is you divide it by 400, and to get the percentage you multiply it by 100. Then you display the name, roll number, percentage and score, and you end your program. The flowchart is the pictorial representation. Since it is defining, your declaration is given in process statement, your read and display is given in parallelogram. Then your task is given in rectangle and you end. This is the program for average computation. First, we will look at the program and then we will move for the executioner. So, we will see what are all the variables needed for the programmer. I need a variable to store the name of the student. So, I have declared a variable name which is capable of holding 20 characters. And I have declared its type as character. In other words, you call it as a character array or string. Then I need a variable to store the roll number and that will be of integer type. Then I need four variables to store four subject marks and a variable to store their sum and a variable to store its average. So I am declaring all this variable as flow data type. Then to be user friendly, I am just printing enter name of the student and I am using an inbuilt function getters which help us to read data from the user in string format. What is the speciality means here you can have space. For example, if I am saying Sumati space L, this space is not generally allowed if you are going to use percentage yes in scanf function. Then I am going to read a roll number using scanf function percentage D, that is the format specifier D is used because the value that I am going to read will be an integer type. Then I am reading a subject marks and I am using F as format specifier because the marks can be in a decimal value. Say it could be 50.5, 70.5. So it could be a decimal value. So I am using F as format specifier. Then I am summing up all the marks. Then I am calculating the average and I am just printing all the data what I have been read. Here I am using the built-in function putters. This helped me to print the string value. And again, I am printing the roll number. To print, I am not using address of operator. When I read the value, I have to use address of operator because I need to know the address to put data into it. When I am retrieving the data, I need not to worry about the address. So, I am not using address of operator. Here, when I am printing the percentage, I am using 2.2f. We know f is meant for decimal value. What is this 2.2? This means that before decimal, I can have two digits and after decimal, I can have two digits. This percentage C means that I'm going to read a character. The character is this percentage. That is any character, any letter that is given within a single quotes, then it is termed as character, right? With this introduction, we will go for the execution. I'm going to use code blocks. So what is code block? It is an integrated development environment. What do you mean by integrated development environment? Generally, if you want to write a C program, you need an editor to type your program, right? You need an editor to type your program. Then you need a compiler to convert you check the errors in your C program. Then you need a runner, right? All this are integrated in your IDE. So we will start. First, I'm just clicking new file, right? I'm going to use I need a C file, right? I need a C file. So what is the name of the file? I have already created a folder C lab exercise. And under this, I'm going to name my file as student average computation, right? And this is already will be saved as .c, right? I have saved the file. Okay, then click finish. Now let me see how the file is created. See, the file is created with the extension .c, right? So I have already saved the program, typed the program in a notepad. So I'm just copying it and pasting it over here. Now the program is being typed in the editor, right? Say now I want to compile it. Once the compilation is done, if you have any errors, that will be listed If you don't have any errors, an object file will be created. As it is an IDE environment, the application file will also be created. The application is nothing but the execution file. So this is meant for builder. That is for compilation and building your execution file. And this is run button. This helps you to run your programs. Either you can use the shortcut buttons or you can go here and make use of your build and run, right? So first I am going to build my program. It is builded. There is no error. Let me see what happens. See, an object file and an application is created. Now I am going to execute it. I am just click the run button. Okay. Run button. So it the first step, enter your name. I'm giving el name. I'm giving the roll number, marks in four subjects. Okay, the result is name of the student, the roll number, percentage C, two digits before and two digits after your decimal point, and the percentage symbol is printed, right? This is how you get your result. Let us see how the things happen. When I compile it, right, the memory will be allotted in the stack for all this variable, all the variables that you have declared. Since the name is declared as a character array of size 20, it starts from indexing 0 to 19, a memory space will be allotted, right? And for roll number, it is integer, and all other of float data type, right? This is how the memory will be allotted during your compilation. And once you run your program, the values will be assigned and you will have a sample result as we see now. With this, today we have seen how to write a simple program using your operators, expressions, and formatting, right? Thank you.